magically are rich. And they'll say, oh, you're so lucky. You're so lucky that you could go on those trips. Or you're so lucky to have that type of life. There's no fucking luck involved. Donate, whatever fundraiser. There's always places that you can make use of your money. So you need to make more money. I am commanding you to start thinking to make more money for these reasons. So you can create these experiences. So you can donate your favorite charities. So you can make an actual impact. You can live a life of freedom and fulfillment. What's up, freaks? Welcome to another episode of the Steve Eckert Show podcast. And today we are talking about money, dinero, moolah, cash, whatever the hell you want to call it. We're going to go deep into money and why you need it. And that doesn't make you greedy or selfish or whatever else you want to call it. We're going to go deep into money on the Steve Eckert Show podcast, which is a show on how to flip the switch, have a no excuses badass mindset, guiding you to adapt, overcome, and destroy the obstacles preventing your success in your mindset, your family, your fitness, and your business. So you can stop being a little bitch, get your shit together, and start living life on your own freaking terms, all while you create your own personal ideal freak freedom lifestyle. And I'll tell you what, in order to create that freak freedom lifestyle, money is going to certainly help you. Is that the only way to do it? No, definitely not. But it's going to help you create some freedom. Money will equal freedom. There's the saying, discipline equals freedom. Yeah, that's true. You hear Jocko say it. But money also equals freedom. We're going to break it down and give you some examples of how that actually freaking happens. And this show is always about learning how to weaponize everything, how to weaponize your weaknesses. Today, we're talking about how to weaponize freaking money. Because you know what? Most people don't understand money. They'll say, let's say you have nice things. You have a nice house or a nice car or whatever. You're going on trips or taking your family out or creating these amazing, memorable experiences with your family. And people say, oh, you're just rich. Like we do one of the programs, we have The Project. If you've been following me at all, you've heard about The Project. We talk about it all the time. And some of the haters will talk about The Project. And they'll say, oh, it's just run by a bunch of old military veterans and some rich dude. So they call Bezos just some rich dude. Like he just was, just appeared on this earth as just some rich dude. Like there's no decades of work and learning and mastery involved in that. Just some rich dude. You just magically are rich. And they'll say, oh, you're so lucky. You're so lucky that you could go on those trips. Or you're so lucky to have that type of life. There's no fucking luck involved. There's nothing lucky about it. There's nothing lucky, and there's no such thing as just rich. Even maybe someone has money passed down and from their family or something. We're not even talking about that. And then on the flip side, there's people that say they're self-made, this and that. On the flip side, there's no such thing as self-made. No one did it by themselves. They have a team. They have a bunch of people they learned from that poured into them, that gave them opportunities. No such thing as self-made. So all this goes into the money stuff. And people say, oh, you're just in it for the money. You're just in it for the money. If you really cared about helping men, we get told that in The Project. If you really cared about helping men, you do it for free. Okay. Or you'd only charge $500 a person. But I'll tell you what. There's other programs that we charge $500 a person. Actually, the Freak Father Alliance is $5.99 right now, $5.99 a month. And you'll still get men that say, oh, that's too expensive. So it doesn't really matter what you're going to charge. You're going to get people that are going to tell you, oh, it's too expensive. If you really cared about helping men, you would charge this amount or less. Everyone's got the bright ideas. They say the project shouldn't be so much. Right now, as of this recording, the project is $18,000. And they say there's no way it costs that much. It should be $500 at most per person because you don't have any expenses because you just run it behind a Walmart. That's what they say. For some reason, they like to say we run it behind a Walmart or a Best Buy. And if people understood business, understood money. People don't have an understanding of money because they think it's just luck and rich and people are just greedy and scammers. And why are you charging so much? It should be free. Anyone who thinks something should be free is just a jackass. Because the project alone, just insurance alone, is somewhere between $25,000 and $30,000+ per class just for liability insurance. Just insurance. That's two people's tuition just to cover the insurance. There's rental vans that need to move the men around. That's a few thousand dollars. There's so many expenses that go into it. There's a building it has to be run at, which costs money. There's people who have to be flown in from all over the place to come and help. There's medics that come in. The medics have to get paid. The medics need a flight coming in. The medics need hotels. There's junior instructors. There's overall combined with instructors and medics and junior instructors and assistants, 12 to 15 people helping out just to run a class to keep things running smoothly to get the effect and the outcome and the impact and the transformations we're looking for. It's such a major project. It's what's called the project. But people that don't understand money think, oh, you should just do it. If you really cared about helping men, well, if you would do it for free. What do you think this podcast is, motherfucker? It's free. Go watch a YouTube channel. It's tons of more time and effort and money being put into the free stuff that's out there by myself and Bedros and anyone else that's in the project or any business, really. If you look at the amount of free stuff that people put out there, it's crazy. And then people say, oh, if you really cared, it would be free. Well, there is tons of free stuff, but unfortunately, something like the project or a coaching program, you have to pay for it. That's just the way it is. It's called business. And maybe if you join those programs, you learn how to properly run a business. Just saying, oh, if you cared about people, you would do it for free. Doesn't make any sense. Why do you charge so much or all this other crap? Then there's the side of people who say money doesn't buy happiness. You can't buy whatever. All these other money can't buy happiness, whatever the hell the other similar sayings there are. But let me tell you what money can buy, what money can do. Money can first create different level, higher level experiences for you, for your family, for your team, for other people. Money can buy you time. I use money all the time to buy myself time so I can spend more time with my kids. So I should just do it for free. I should do everything for free. Be broke, be hungry, but just keep pouring into people for free, which also will make me not be able to spend any time with my family. That's what I should do, and that's how I should coach people to live their life. No, we're going to practice what we preach and show them how you could buy time with your money so you can have time to do more of what you actually want to do or should be doing, like, oh, I don't know, maybe hanging out with your family, with your kids, being a father for once. Just because you have kids doesn't make you a father. Just because you're a male doesn't make you a man. Money can buy you time. Money can buy you freedom. Money can buy you the type of lifestyle you want to live. Like, I have a specific type of lifestyle I want to live. Part of it requires money. So I'm going to bust my ass and work hard like I've done for the last, Yeah, it's been luck for the last 35 fucking years of working and busting my ass to build up businesses and to make enough money to live the lifestyle I want to live, to be able to take my family with me when I have to travel for work. Or one time I was traveling just to Texas just to speak for an hour. But to go to Texas, it was a 3-day event. I wanted to be able to experience the whole event and also attend the rest of the event when I wasn't speaking, watch all the others speak. But then that would mean I have to get there a day early, 3 days of the event, a travel day back, 5 days away from the family. Money allowed me to be able to go. And this is a free speaking engagement I was doing. There's sometimes it's paid, sometimes it's free. You decide what's going to be the best return on your investment. A lot of times it's worth it to do things like that for free. I paid my own airfare, paid my own hotel to speak for this 1 hour for free, but I also want to experience the entire event. So that's 5 days out of my time that I'd be away from my family. Money allowed me to first be able to go do this for free, to go pour into this group and help coach them and teach them and guide them, to pour into them. Money allowed me to stay there for 3 days so I can learn and soak in and level myself up in my own personal development and self-mastery. But it also allowed me to take my family with me to pay for their airline tickets, to have the hotel for the amount of time we needed to be there, to get rental cars and whatever else we needed to do. and Ubers and back and forth and meals and food and everything. Money allowed me to do that. So I can go and serve other people, volunteer to serve other people, learn myself and level up, and take the family along for the ride without having to be away from my family for 5 days. That's what we're talking about what money can do for you. The way you need to start thinking about money. Instead of going to make a buck doing something that's making you miserable and you're away from your family for a bunch of days at a time to make enough money just to keep the lights on. Yes, that's an honorable thing to do and the baseline of what's expected of you as a man, but that's just a price of admission. It is your duty and obligation to make more money so that you can live the type of lifestyle you want to live. So you don't have to neglect your family in order just to make a living. To be able to travel the way you want to travel and go on a cruise and get those experiences. Travel to countries you've never seen before. Shit, when I was a kid, I never left New York and New Jersey. The first time I was ever on a plane was on a free plane paid for by the government to go to South Carolina, Paris Island, for Marine Corps boot camp. The first time I was ever on a plane, that was actually the first time I was ever out of New York and New Jersey area. Never been outside of New York and New Jersey until I was 19 years old on a plane paid for by the government to go send me to boot camp. And as I traveled around, was in Japan and all over this country and in the desert and in the jungle and all the different places that they sent me just to go and train and work, realizing there's so much more out there. And the only way to do it is not relying on someone to pay for it like the government is doing. If I want to do that with a family, it's going to require some freaking money to be able to take your family along for the ride, to be able to go on those trips. To be able to then buy an RV that we bought so I can work on the road and use the RV to travel for business all the time, but take the family along for the ride with me so we could all work, go, they can go with me when I'm working. Also then, I crashed the RV in like the first 2 weeks of having it, crashed it. Almost $20,000 worth of damage, smashed the top of the RV, crushed the whole top of it, and not freaking out about it. Of course, you know insurance is going to cover it. You're going to have a deductible. It's going to cost you money for the deductible. It's probably going to raise your insurance rates, but not stressing it, not freaking out about it. And if for some reason the insurance didn't cover it, knowing that I'm going to have to pay for it myself, okay, I'm not going to freak out about it because you never know what's going to happen. You never know when your family member is going to get sick. Also, how about this? You say, oh, I don't need that much money. Okay, but does your family maybe need a little money? Do your neighbors need a little money? Do your friends maybe need a little money? How about strangers or donating to different charities or the military fundraisers that we do all the time or for animals or for kids or for child trafficking or whatever you want to donate, whatever fundraiser, there's always places that you can make use of your money. So you need to make more money. I am commanding you to start thinking to make more money for these reasons. So you can create these experiences, so you can donate your favorite charities, so you can make an actual impact. You can live a life of freedom and fulfillment. Not to say you can't have freedom and fulfillment without money, but it makes it a whole lot fucking easier and it helps you create these different higher level experiences. And this is the kind of shit they don't teach in school. They don't teach you shit about money in school, how to make money, sales and marketing. Like if you don't learn the basics of sales and marketing, like, shame on you. That's like the base level, no matter what your job is, no matter what industry you're in, you need to learn sales and marketing, at least on a base level, so that you have those skills that when you need to go make some money, you need to market something, you need to sell something, that you have those as base level skills, those high income generating skills, those high level skills of sales and marketing. They don't teach that shit in school. That's the kind of subjects they should be teaching in high school. You should be in a sales class. A marketing class, think about that, more useful, not wasting your fucking time learning about the size of a T-Rex's claw. They don't teach that shit in school. When we first moved to California, we have a nice pool and a jacuzzi out there in our home, our dream house that we're here, a ton of land for the dogs and the animals to run wild on. We have like a freaking zoo here. And solar panels on the roof. We're in California, so we're gonna weaponize the sun for power. We first moved here, I guess it wasn't fully connected correctly to the electric, whatever, the solar panels. I thought it was. For some reason, it wasn't connected to the pool and the jacuzzi. But California winter, at nighttime, it gets pretty cold out here in the desert areas, Southern California. And so I had the pool heater on nonstop. 24 hours a day for about 2.5-3 months. Now, all the bills are on auto. If you're productive, working on productivity, all things are auto pay. Automatically, all the bills get paid automatically every month. So you don't have to waste time. You check in on them. But the bills like that are always on a delay. They're after you've used it, you pay for it. So we had 2 months in a row, or maybe even 3 months, I think. It was like $4,500, $5,500, and then something like $5,000. 3 months in a row for the gas and electric gas bill. For running a pool. So literally it was close to $15,000 within 3 months. That's almost as much as the mortgage is. Think about that. On top of all the other bills and expenses you have, and it automatically just got pulled out of the bank account. Now that could be devastating and crushing to you if you only have a couple thousand dollars in the bank. You'll be dead broke from this. That's why you never know what fuck ups are going to happen. You never know what emergencies are going to come across your family where you need money to help someone out. Shit, you never know when you're going to have to bail a motherfucker out of jail. But luckily, I have a good understanding of money and why there's a need for money, why there's a need for investing, why there's a need to learn sales and marketing, that why there's a need to have enough expenses, a certain amount of months of expenses always saved up, and emergency funds and different investments and diversifying your money. That when that bill came through and we got fucked over that bill, that it wasn't the end of the world. Did it suck? Hell yeah, it sucked. Did it fucking sting? Wasting almost 15 freaking G's on a freaking warm pool that we went in a few times a week over those months? Hell yeah, it did. Hell of a lesson to learn too. Pay better attention. Keep a little tighter a supervision over your money, over all your different bills that automatically come out. Keep an eye on them or have someone at least keeping an eye on them. Lessons learned. Lesson learned, motherfucker. Expensive lesson, but not freaking out about it, not being the end of the world because you understand money and that's why it's your duty and obligation to have this money. When we've gone on trips in the past, we've been able to, even before we did homeschooling or before we had an RV and we would go to workshops, we'd travel with the kids when they were younger, when they still needed babysitters, and we would find different services that are in those towns that send a babysitter to your hotel and they watch the kids in the hotel for you the entire day until you get back from the workshop. And those babysitters were expensive as hell at the time. But knowing that you have a duty and obligation to make money to allow you to live the lifestyle that you want to live, I didn't want to have to leave the kids at home or get someone to stay with them at home or get family members to come in there and spend that time away from the kids. You want to spend as much time as you can. Otherwise, what's the point of building this empire if you're having to neglect the people that you claim you're building it for, and money allows you to do shit like that? And then being able to fix mistakes like the RV, like the heater bill. Also, there was a birthday party. We had a birthday party. This is just last year. There's supposed to be a company that came in and set up these jelly ball wars for them. And it was like, I don't even know, $500 or $800 for the amount of kids it was. They bring all these guns in for you. They give you the jelly ammo for it. And they set up all the games and they like run these games for you. You rent the equipment. They come in there and they facilitate it. And literally, like an hour before they're supposed to be there, they say, oh, we forgot to tell you, we don't service your area. You're too far out there in California, in the area that you're at. We don't service that area. So we're not coming. Literally like an hour before they're supposed to be there. The party already started, waiting for them to show up and then find out they're not coming. Like, oh shit, what do I do? I, without hesitation, jumped in the car, went over to Walmart, found the exact guns, actually better guns than the ones that these people bring, and bought them. So now we have them. We still have them. Bought enough for all the kids there. Bought a bunch of rifles, a bunch of pistols. Bought tens and tens of thousands of rounds of ammo that we still haven't run out of yet for these jelly balls. And it cost a shitload of money for that I wasn't expecting to spend. It cost more than for the people to come in to rent the stuff. And actually not even that much more, but it cost a more. But now we have that stuff for life. But money allowed me to unfuck that situation, to fix that situation and not have a birthday party that was ruined that all these kids are waiting there to play with and just showing up with bags and bags like freaking the Walmart ghetto Santa Claus with some Walmart bags with shitloads of these jelly ball guns. Money allows that, made that to happen. And then the next stage of that is teaching your kids about money, to make money, to start their own businesses, having them read books and courses and YouTube videos to learn the skills on how to make money. and yourself, investing in yourself, in mentors and guides. You have to spend money to learn to invest in yourself. That's the number one investment you could ever make, is in yourself, in hiring a coach. The previous episode of the podcast we did was all about coaching. And you need to be able to invest in yourself to start a business. But teach your kids about money, the responsibility of money. Have them start working for you. Our kids work for us. They have jobs. They have, of course, their own chores, their own homeschooling stuff. But they have different jobs that make them money, that allow them to make money by helping us with things that normally a kid wouldn't have to do, that they choose to do, different jobs, different tasks to help us with business or whatever. So people who say money doesn't make you happy or you can't buy happiness, guess what? They never had any fucking money. Or they never gave enough money away. Or they never did anything meaningful enough with their freaking money. So I'm going to challenge you to this. It is your duty and obligation as a man to go and make more money. Learn these skills. Make more money. Be smarter with your money. But the best thing to do is not be smarter with your money. People think money management is this. They think it's, all right, let me look at my expenses and see where can I cut my expenses so I can stop spending so much money so I'll have more. In the time it takes you to learn how to save $100 a month, in the time that it takes you to do that, you could have built up, gotten some leads or made some sales or something in business that would make you 10 times or 100 times that amount. So first worry about making more money, worrying about cutting expenses. Then yeah, you could also additionally cut some expenses, but it's gonna be a 10-to-1 investment on making more money rather than cutting expenses. So it is your duty and obligation as a man, I'm challenging you to go out and make some more freaking money. If you wanna learn about how to do some of these things and implement some of these things in sales and marketing and business and how to make more money, and how to live the life on your own terms and what it's going to take to get there, and then reverse engineer that in your actual life, send me a message. We could talk about it. This is the kind of stuff that we work on in our one-on-one high-level coaching and also in our men's mentorship group coaching program, which is actually that money is one of the M's of the Freak Father Alliance men's mentorship group coaching. It's all about the mindset, the muscles, the money, the meaning, the mastery, and the mission. That's what it's about. So if you need some help learning how to do that, how to make more money, send me a message. We'll talk all about it. I'll let you know how you can get on board with the Freak Father Alliance group coaching program. And in the meantime, go make some more motherfucking money. And in case no one told you yet today, you are fucking awesome. No excuses.